the last but not the least, influence of ultra-fine grained structure produced by equal channel angular pressing on dynamic response on and fracture of pure copper. Ivan Smirnov and Alexander Konstantinov. I suppose that Ivan Smirnov will.
Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Thank you very much for the presentation. And let's start. It is well known that the strength of polycrystalline materials depends on grain size, can be shown by the Hall Pesch relationship. Here you see the example for titanium. That's why nanocrystalline and ultra-fine grained materials have broad studies, and this material demonstrates very high strengths, very high yield strengths, very high hardness. However, most of nanocrystalline and ultra-fine grained materials have a very low ductility, except some results in literature for copper and titanium. This result demonstrates possibility of so-called paradox of high strength and high ductility of metals. And that's why main topic in this field is how to increase ductility of ultra-fine grained materials. However, in these studies, researchers for characterization of mechanical parameters of ultra-fine grained materials usually use approach based on strength of materials when applied loads correspond some parameters of strain stress strain curve. And approach based on fracture mechanics remains without special attention. However, it is very important for practical application, and moreover, fracture mechanics adopts an entirely new approach for designing against fracture. And second point of our motivation is that modern constructions and devices are often operated in condition of tense high speed and shock load. But literature survey shows that this data very represented very poor. This is why we decide to study fracture and dynamic response of ultra-fine grained materials. And we started on example of pure copper. Why copper? Because these very simple single phase materials which has very good repeatability of structure with after differing processing, and the structure studied in detail. We involved four states of structure of copper. First one is material in delivery state. This material was produced in the form of cold rolled hard tempered rods. Second is material after annealing. Annealing provide homogeneous and fully recrystallized structure needed for severe plastic deformation. And another two correspond the structure with ultra-fine grains, which were produced by severe plastic deformation. Severe plastic deformation was carried out by means of method equal channel angular pressing. This method, unlike traditional methods of severe plastic deformation, provide more higher degree of deformation, which need for providing homogeneous ultra-fine grain structure with grain size up to several hundreds of nanometers. degree of deformation depends on number of passes through channels, and we used four end passes. Here you see the characteristic parameters of copper after different treatment. Decrease in grain size leads to increase tensile strains, yield strains, total elongation of ultra-fine grained materials more than total elongation materials in delivery state, but less than materials in after annealing. Here you see the result for quasi-static tension with different temperature. Increased temperature leads to decrease of tensile strains for both state of material. However, total elongation increase with temperature for ultra-fine grained material and decrease with temperature for coarse-grained material. That is usual situation for coarse-grained material. First point of our study is dynamic bending of beams with V-shaped notch. The test will carry out by means of drop tower impact system at impact velocity 5 meters per second and impact energy about 150 joules. Additional test will carry out for 10 meters per second and temperature minus 50 and 100 Celsius degree. Force curves were registered by means of strain gauge embedded in impactor, and the deflection curves were calculated by double integration of the force time curve. Here you see the result of tests, typical results. Three upper curve correspond sample fractured samples, and bottom curve correspond material in annealing state, which not demonstrate fracture and was and exhibit only intensive plastic deformation. That's why we can speak in terms of impact toughness, and further we will compare results in terms of consumed energy. Consumed energy can be considered as energy before peak of loading, and consumed energy consumed on full process of fracture or deformation. Here you see the dependencies of such consumed energy on force rate or temperature. As you see, materials with ultra-fine grain structure, material with ultra-fine grain structure, have higher consumed energy before peak of loading than material in delivery state. Moreover, strain force stress sensitivity entwines more than for material in delivery state. It is well known that materials with FCC crystalline lattice do not exhibit cold brittleness. However, it is very important to see how these materials materials behavior under different temperature. So we see that material with ultra-fine grain structure have a sensitivity for temperature, and also we see that total energy of ultra-fine grained materials higher than total consumed energy for annealing material after three-point bending test. The second point, our dynamic compression. Second point, our test is dynamic compression cylindrical samples on the setup with a split Hopkinson pressure bar. The samples were in the form cylinder with diameter of 8 millimeters and length of 4 millimeters. Two strain rates were considered. Here you see the results of experiments. Left upper picture presents the stresses in the samples. Right picture presents diagram stress strain diagrams, and bottom left picture presents stress rate dependence of yield stress strengths, which were defined as 0.2% of deformation. So we see that degree of deformation for all materials close to each other for the same strain rate. However, yield strengths for ultra-fine-grained materials more higher than for coarse-grained material. You can see it on the left bottom picture. Strain rate sensitivity more pronounced in for coarse-grained material and material with 4 passes of ECIP have more less pronounced strain rate sensitivity. To exclude consideration the possible influence on effect of friction inertia, we calculate this inertia by means of formula presented by Malinowski, Klepachki, and Kovalevsky. And as we see, the influence of these effects of friction inertia is negligible. So, why this material, demonstrate so different behavior of strain rate sensitivity? It can be explained by consideration of structure. Mishra and colleagues shown that coarse-grained material have large grains and high-low grain boundaries, high-angle grain boundaries. The material after 4 passes of ECIP has small size, small grains, and low angle, high fraction of low angle grain boundaries. And materials after 8 passes has small grains and large fraction of high angle grain boundaries. On the second report of this section, the application of incubation time approach to dynamic yielding was considered. Let's consider how it can be applied to our in our tests. So you see calculated curves. Only 2 parameters were used for calculation. It is yield strengths and incubation time. This incubation time fully characterize the behavior of material states of materials under different strain traits. Moreover, if we supply that strain rate dependence of yield stress has a linear character on all range of strain rates, then we can receive intersection this curve. It means that coarse grain material will have more high yield strengths than ultra fine grain materials. It is very important for practical point of view because and should be taken by experiment. Here you see some summary of my report, and it is repeat of my report. We can finish and answer the question.
Thank you, Mr. Smirnov. Have you any question regarding this paper? Yes, please.
Also connected with the second presentation. What, can you explain me what is the incubation time?
Could you repeat, please, explain what?
The incubation time. Can you go back to your previous? Okay. Yeah, here, tau.
Yes.
Tau is incubation time. What does it mean?
Okay, it is incubation time of plasticity which characterize structural process which provide plasticity behavioral material. For any material can have specified process, but it is integral characteristics which not consider particular processes in the structure. So it is characterized time of process.
Of which process? I cannot imagine.
Okay, when you...
To the movement or formation of a dislocation, what is it? 0.2
microseconds. Okay, let's consider the experiment. Tension, for example, when you test your sample, different process can happen in structure. So it depends on metals, it depends on strain rate. So even in static, when you test your sample in the microstructure, all process and dynamic. Dynamic it means time. So all process characterized have characterized time for they happen. So incubation time it is characterized time of process for plasticity. When we test our material for brittle fracture, it's time characterize crack propagation, micro crack propagation, micro void nucleation, and so on.
Any question more regarding this paper? If we have not, thank you, Mr. Smirnov. Now, we have one question for Mr. Reza Talemi.